Control levels have gotten so incredibly smart and complex in Mario Maker 2. Unfortunately, Nintendo doesn't want us to be able to open these up in an editor to see how they're done, so I'm here to explain to you 5 cool setups and troll levels you may have seen some streamers play recently. I'd love to make this a regular series, so if there are any trolls and videos by your favorite Mario players, post the link to the video along with a timestamp and what the troll is, and I'd love to explain how it's done in a future video. Just to clarify, I'm not claiming that these absolutely are the setups in the following levels, so if there are multiple ways to do a setup, I'll just be showing one of those ways. So let's begin. So we're here in this section and there's not much to do and we think we did something wrong and go to kill ourselves in the lava, and what do you know, you can actually stand on the lava. The way it's done is you bring up the lava high enough to put a bomb and a stack of 2 munchers under the lava and chain chomps on top. The lava makes the bombs explode, which kills the chomps and leaves just the stumps. And when most things stack, they will sink a little bit in height, so this little bit leaves just enough room for the stumps to be hidden, but also just high enough to save you. Now, because this troll requires chain chomp stumps, you'll always see a level try to hide it, like in this case where you start from above the lava and the explosion happens below you. But if the level just started with the pipe here, you'd see the explosion and the chomp stumps, and it'd ruin the surprise. This next setup isn't specific to troll levels, but it is a setup that you won't be able to do if you just try to drag the items in place. As you can see here, the big muncher is centered, and the 3 blasters are all perfectly even on top of it. Centering a 2-block-wide enemy can be done in a couple of ways, but this way can actually be seen if you look closely when entering the room. Basically, this little bomb stacked under the big muncher will center it, and there's a flying block here which crushes the bomb and the blocks, allowing the muncher to stay centered as it falls. Then the blasters fall down with it and land perfectly centered. It's actually important that the blasters fall rather than being stacked on the muncher from the start, like this, because like I said earlier, when something is stacked, it usually sinks down slightly, and in this case, you can see that the middle blaster does if you stack it. This trigger is used in lots of troll levels all over the place and is based on the player's horizontal position. It triggers an off-screen switch when you move beyond this point here. Let's take a look above at the setup. This is based off of 2 factors. 1, moles always follow your horizontal position, and 2, muncher hitboxes are really weird. If I add some ground right below, you can see that when I start on the left, the mole is trying to chase me, but he can't move. And then as soon as my position goes beyond here, he changes directions. When he changes directions, the muncher moves just a tiny bit, which is enough to crush the bomb, making it set off the switch. It is also possible to do this setup with a thwomp positioned at just the right spot, but it would trigger at a slightly different spot. It also shakes the screen, and sometimes you want a switch to be triggered cleanly without a screen shake. Also, sometimes you can get a hint into how the contraption was made in the level by what things go flying when the action happens, and here in the actual level, we can see the mole. This silly contraption is a wonderful troll because it works perfectly every time and is just absurd. From the way it looks, the setup always seems to know when you're on the left or the right side, and it moves the blasters to the other side before you can get to them. It also seems to always switch directions when you get to the second donut, and there's no way to trigger it when you're at the first. First, let's get an overview of the setup. We have a long span of switching conveyors, all facing the left direction, with 2 tall blasters. These question blocks crush the bomb, killing the chain chomp, which leaves the stumps. Outside of the scroll stop view, we see 2 setups that are almost exactly mirrored, except both conveyors are facing left. So how does it work? The changing conveyor down here starts in the left direction, and over here, left out of view because of the scroll stop, we have a special arrangement of things, so let's see it in action without the scroll stop. As you can see, when we first enter the room, the conveyor on the left is moving to the left, which clears the path for the thwomp to hit the switch if the player gets to the second donut. Over here on the right side, the conveyor is moving to the left also because we want this muncher to block the thwomp from hitting the switch if the player goes over here first. Without the muncher, we could run over to the right when we enter the room, and there'd be nothing blocking the switch from being triggered, so then the platform would come your way and defeat the entire purpose of the troll. Now that we know the switch won't be triggered if the player goes to the right side first, look what happens when the player goes to the left first. The thwomp falls when you get to the second donut, and it switches the big conveyor at the bottom and this mini conveyor to the right direction. This mini conveyor needs to move to the right so the muncher can block the thwomp from hitting the switch again. Then we look over here, and since this other mini conveyor is going to the right, now there's room for the thwomp to hit the switch. So we go to the second donut, and just like on the left side, the thwomp hits the switch on the right, which moves the big conveyor and the two mini conveyors back to the left. This last troll is one that triggers an on-off switch as soon as you start falling and get close enough to the flag. Nothing else triggers it beforehand, so you can jump all around and nothing will happen. But once you drop to the flag, the switch is hit, trapping you in here. So how does it work? This troll is based off the fact that moving platforms don't begin moving until they're within a specific range, vertically or horizontally, of the screen. So when we start the room, the creator made sure there is no way to scroll the screen down by two blocks. What ends up happening is that when the screen scrolls close enough to the platform, it begins to move upward and it pushes the muncher up to crush the bomb, which triggers the switch. Technically, the platform begins to move while you're at this block, but because the contraption does take a few frames to trigger, that's just enough time for you to fall a bit further to get stuck here. So there you have it, 5 great setups that are easy to put together and require just a little bit of advanced thinking. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. If you did, don't forget to leave a like. Like I said before, I'd love to start doing this as a series, so if there are any trolls and levels played by your favorite Mario players, post a comment with a link to the video along with the timestamp and what troll it is, and I'd love to explain how it's done in a future video. So if you'd like to see more videos like this, let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.